Why you add the voltages by batteries in series? You could explain this with a water analogy. Yeah, see Wikipedia, there it is very good explained. If you place two water pumps in series, then one pump pumps the water, for example, 1 meter higher, and the other pump in series pumps it again 1 meter higher. In total, you pump the water then 2 meters higher. Just adding. Now, a battery is a kind of electron pump. If you place, for example, two batteries of 1 volt in series, then one battery pumps the electrons 1 volt higher, and the other one again 1 volt higher. The total voltage difference becomes then 2 volt. But connecting the plus pole of one battery with the minus pole of the other one, it is possible. Won't you get some kind of short circuit? What happens then? Now, the following isn't a perfect scientific explanation, but just an attempt to understand the process a little bit. Let's take as an example a zinc copper galvanic cell. Just one cell. And see what happens when you connect two of them in series. One, two in series. First, we place a zinc electrode in a container with a solution of zinc sulfate. Zinc electrode, zinc sulfate solution. An amount of zinc atoms will dissolve from the electrode into the solution. Until the created electric potential difference between the zinc electrode and the solution is that high, that this process stops. Any zinc atom that likes to dissolve then is stopped by the force exerted by the negative electrons left in the electrode and by the extra zinc 2 plus ions in the solution. There is equilibrium when the voltage difference between the electrode and the solution is minus 0.76 volt. This is just a property of zinc. Zinc is a base metal and therefore eager to go inside the solution zinc 2 plus. And this is the standard potential. I've tried to illustrate this in the following carton. Don't laugh. The zinc atoms like to dissolve in a solution, but when there are already many inside the solution, any new atoms that like to dissolve are stopped by the negative charge of the electrons left in the electrode and the positive charge of the zinc atoms already in solution. The potential difference will not become greater than minus 0.76 volt. Now we place a copper electrode in another container with a solution of copper sulfate. An amount of copper ions will leave the solution and plate, connect on the electrode. Until the created electric potential difference between the copper electrode and the solution is that high that this process stops. When equilibrium is reached, the potential difference, the voltage between the copper electrode and the solution will be plus 0.34 volt, the standard potential. This is just a property of the copper. Copper is a noble metal and is therefore eager to leave the solution to plate on the electrode. Again a carton. The copper ions will like to leave the solution and to plate on the electrode. Although they liberate energy by doing so, there will be a moment that the positively charged copper atoms already in electrode and the negatively charged SO4 ions in solution impede that any more copper ions leave the solution. The potential difference will not become greater than plus 0.34 volt. Note that the electric potential in the electrode will be higher than the one of the solution. Although in a drawing it looked like if it would be lower, but it is just to make a similarity with the real world. Now we connect in series two galvanic cells, two batteries, one and two. Through the salt bridges here and there, SO4 two minus ions can flow, or some other type of ions. The middle copper and zinc electrodes are connected by conducting wire. Everything is in equilibrium. But what has happened with the zinc electrode in a third container when we connected it to the copper electrode? Now, cartoon to clarify this. Some electrons will have flowed to the copper electrode. They are gone here, leaving a positive charge. Yeah, an extra positive charge in the zinc electrode. Now, this will cause in turn that extra zinc atoms will dissolve into the solution until the potential difference is again 0.76 volt and equilibrium has been reached. It does not matter what is the absolute potential of the zinc electrode or the copper electrode. If you connect an electrode to something and you change its absolute potential compared to the earth, then just an amount of zinc and or copper atoms will leave and or enter into the solution until equilibrium has been reached again. And the standard potential differences are again minus 0.76 volt for the zinc electrode and plus 0.34 volt for the copper electrode. That the absolute potentials are not important, but yet the potential difference, you could understand perhaps with the following comparison. Imagine that one person is pulling at your left arm. Two persons are pulling at your right arm. Everybody has the same strength. And then, that 100 persons are pulling at your left arm, and 101 persons are pulling at your right arm. The net result will be the same, provided that your arms are strong enough. Now go back to again to the two connected galvanic cells. And now imagine that we are a small positive charged particle Q, and we want to travel from the left minus pole to the right plus pole. Let's see what happens. First, we leave the zinc electrode and go inside the solution. To do this, we have to force ourselves against the potential difference of 0.76 volt, so like climbing a hill. Inside the solution, the potential is everywhere the same, thus we don't have to do any work to go there. Then we want to go inside the copper electrode, and we have to do some work, some labor. Yeah. To battle the potential difference of 0.34 volt. Now, from the copper electrode to the zinc electrode, the potential is everywhere the same, they are connected, and we don't have to do any work. Then we go inside the solution and we have to work to do work again to battle the 0.76 volt. Inside the solution, potential is everywhere the same, and we don't have to do any labor. And to go inside the copper electrode, again, we have to do some work to battle the potential difference of 0.34 volt. The total energy labor that we have to do will be about 2 volt multiplied by our charge. Now, this explanation isn't perfect, but I hope it's now understandable that when you place batteries in series, you have to add the voltages. Thank you for listening.